I look at life and I realize inside life we can see life. And people will always come to want to say they have a life, to want to be within the life. And they want to say they want to be in your life, to enjoy the life. And you don't know they have a knife to kill your life. And you just say to yourself, you don't want them to waste their life because you know they don't have a life before coming to your life. And all what they want to do is to keep your life with their knife because they got the knife from the father and their mother that does not have a life. So when you have them in your life and they don't have a life, all they want to do is to get the knife to cut your life short and waste your life. I just want to tell you this. You can say, I know I've got some people in my life that I look at them and I look at them and they think I'm running against them or running away from them because they have a knife. And they didn't know I'm only ignoring their life because they don't have a life with their life. That what I have in my life is what God has given to me, that in Him I have a life. And He has given me a life, that is why I am alive, to ignore every knife or anyone who does not have a life that want to kill me with a knife. So that is why I just want to tell you, it's not about who I know, what I know, who you know, and what you do. It's about the life that I have in the life of Jesus that is helping me in everything I do. Remember when I started the ministry, I started the ministry alone. So you cannot understand the mystery of the ministry more than the one who started the ministry with me. So that you started the ministry with me does not mean you are part of the ministry. And that is why you have to look at the mystery as a magic. Because you are part of the vision. You can see the vision, but you're not part of the vision. Many of you join the vision because you watch the television to understand the vision. But I want to tell you, with my vision, I have a mission greater than the television. And that is why I will never look at anybody that will attack the commission because of their negative vision. I have my own mission, working in the vision of God, telling the devil that he's a liar, that I'm too loaded to be distorted and to be wasted. That when I'm good to go, I'm good to go. I'm going to bust the bubble for the devil. I bust the bubble. Why God? Because God is stable and is able and is capable to use his cable to bust the bubble. And anytime anybody want to bubble the bubble, they want to bust the bubble, I bust their head. That's in the name of Jesus, every knee is going to bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. I want to introduce my new me to you. My new me is, if anybody want to live my life, let the person live. I want to introduce my new me to you. My new me is, I am prophetically mean to say to the devil, since the time of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence and the violence taken it by force. My new me means I do not need any family because I don't want to have familiar problems. I came alone and I don't want everybody to add their problems to my problems. Don't bring your negativity to my own celebrity, because your negativity introduces you to calamities. That is making you go against celebrity because you have no ability in God's capacity, in his own ability to be a celebrity. That is why your mentality is full of negativity. And maybe you don't know that God is the obatio munity, obatio shenity, obatio nonity, obatio gbanity, obatio munity, obatio lanity, obatio funini immunity, tayo le jali ni mutofile munity, tofile pani, tofile ni, tofile ni, tofile pakpa, tofile, tofile losi fiditi, ti won fi fidelity to you to need immunity, let him manage your community. And that is what I want to tell you today, that when you expect too much from people, you expect too small as part of your destiny.